Why am I going like that? I'll tell you for why. I've found a different Innocent Gun beer that I haven't either had to order online from, you know, from Sweden or somewhere like that, or I haven't had to take a trip all the way to Canada or America for. I found, and it's actually a lager. So I've got a Innocent Gun lager. I don't know what to make of that, because Innocent Gun are, as far as I'm concerned, a one-trick pony that are very good at their trick that they do. You know, why change the trick when it's fantastic? Excuse me. I've got all sorts. Got a cold, but there you go. Right, yeah, so I've always thought they're a bit of a one-trick pony with every single beer that they do, be it a stout or whatever. They've all got that kind of malty, sugary, sort of demerara and muscovado, sort of rich, sort of rummy sort of flavours. And yeah, they do have a lot of kind of a lot of variations on it. But it's a big kind of background note. And the thing is, if you're an artist, you paint in a certain style, and these guys brew in a certain style. And all their beers have got a very Innocent Gun kind of one-trick pony about them. But it's a fantastic trick, you know. Now, that trick doesn't lend itself to that sort of malty sort of sweetness. Doesn't lend itself to lager, I wouldn't imagine, anyway. So, we'll see how we go. Oh, that come off a bit too easy. But we've got the thingy coming off there. That was very loose cap. But, it's, you know, there you go. Plain crown. Better come off very, very easy. What are we talking here? This one? I think this one we're going to go. Right, I think we're going to have room to pour the... Of course, very, very, very light. But for a start, it's got a natural head. I'm pouring a lot in here. Natural head. It's not got like E405 head and things like that. Nice and natural. Natural carbonation there going on. Nice gentle carbonation. Have a little twirl on the smell. Yeah, the head's dying down quite quickly, but that's nice. That's refreshing. Very gentle little notes, little kind of lemony notes, little grapefruit notes, little biscuity notes, little wafer notes. Gentle, lovely, almost Pilsner-like. Nice smells. So let's have a little taste. Cheers, everyone. Very gentle, very subtle, smooth. Smooth. There's the kind of bitter aftertaste that comes in quite late is a little bit strange. It seems like it's on its own. There's like a nice little kind of current of nice, smooth, little velvety, soft little notes. That ain't, you know, that are not too malty and they're nice and delicate and everything else. And then you've got this somewhere else in the distance. It's just like, and you go, whoa, hold on, what's that? Am I hearing something? It's like, you know, like a beautiful choir in a church somewhere and all the lovely sounds and, you know, and then it's yeah, someone's baby's going on. What? Right in the back row somewhere. And there's something that's discorded in there. And it's a nice one, nice lager, but it seems it's just not weighing in there. It's metallic and discordant and that. Almost like the water itself has got a high iron content or something. Aluminium content or something like that. Yeah. I'm not sure I'm mad on that. It's not inspirational. So I think Innocent Gun have kind of stepped outside of their comfort zone and stepped outside onto like a landmine or whatever, you know. Leave this alone, boys. Leave it alone. It's nice that you're kind of trying different things, but you guys, you know, you're good at what you do. You're brilliant at what you do. You're ace at what you do. You're fantastic. You know, it's like getting Van Gogh and saying, "Can you paint me house?" You know, it's like, well, I don't know if he would. I don't know if he could. You know, he could certainly paint a painting, but could he paint your house? Would your door look nice and that? You know, pardon me. Not inspirational. So what does it say on the back? Just quickly. Our lager takes its inspiration from the German beer style Helles. Really? Meaning light coloured. That's brewed in Munich. Else as a hoppiness, no, a pronounced malty flavour, no it doesn't, balanced with a light aromatic hoppiness. Don't know about that, which makes it very refreshing indeed. And usually, as well as our unique Scottish malts, we have added some naked golden oats, that's probably what's not nice, to the brew, which impart a satisfying smoothness to the finish. Yes, it's got a smoothness, as I said, but I'm not keen on it. That's a shame. I've drunk a tiny little bit out of that, and it feels like I've drunk 4 pints of it. It's kind of very, you know. It's hard going, very hard going. So Innocent Gun, that is, I never thought I'd find an Innocent Gun beer that I'm deeply unimpressed by, and I'm really unimpressed by it. So, would you believe they've actually put that in a brown bottle, suffering probably from a lot of kind of pressure, especially from abroad. It seems everyone abroad goes, "Oh, clear bottle, it's skunky." As soon as I open it, oh, skunky, yeah. All right. Never heard such a lot of bloody nonsense. Sorry. And I'm sorry to those that, you know, abroad that do say that. But, oh, blimey. I'm sure it travels over there. They don't leave it out in the light and out on the decks and everything else. I don't know. It just seems that every time someone gets it abroad, it's like they get it in the clear bottle. Oh, skunky already. I pull the cap off first, can you? So they've, obviously, they've bowed to the pressure and gone, "Okay, boys, I'm sorry. We'll get to do what you want tonight." Yeah. Why don't you put it in a carton? Put it in a big one of these, like, plastic cartons. Put it in a can, you know. Everyone seems to be on cans nowadays. Cans, yeah, you can't wear any light through cans. Yeah, you can't see the beer either, you know. But there you go. Merry Christmas and all that. Anyway, yeah, don't really bother with that. That's kind of a waste of time, that one. Unless it's really, really cheap. And I wouldn't pay for it. I think I paid the £4 or £5 in Tesco's that they're doing, £1.25 a bottle. Yeah, even at that, I'm unimpressed. What did I have a little while ago? I had one of these jobbies here, works out about 90p a bottle, 89p a bottle or something, a can, 500, and that's 330 millilitres. And that was a lot better. So this one, struggle. Cheers, everyone. I'm going to try not down it in front of you. Get it out of the glass. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up. Biddly boo. Where the man could wait, where the man